Hello everyone, I'm Smriti Sinha and I'm here to introduce you to my channel Science Zone. Today you follow, tomorrow we lead. I have qualified the various exams. One of the exams is the MSc exam, which I have qualified from University of Pune, and the NEET/SET GATE PET exams. I will ensure you that you will be able to score good marks in your board exams. I will also prepare you for various entrance exams. The thing just you have to do is subscribe my channel and watch all my lectures regularly. Share this lecture to more and more of your friends so that I can get inspired to make better lectures for you. Today, whole world is in lockdown, but everyone has the access to internet. So what are you waiting for? Do not stop your studies. The main aim of my channel is to make online education available for everyone, and that too free of cost. To clear your doubts, you can even mail it to my Gmail ID, which will be provided to you at the end of my every video. All your doubts will be cleared as soon as possible. If you show good support to me, to my channel, we will also make lectures available for other subjects like physics, maths and biology. So what are you waiting for? Just go down and hit the subscribe button below and let's get started. So let us discuss the chemistry syllabus in brief. So we are going to begin actually with chemistry. So the chemistry syllabus of the Maharashtra Board Standard 12th. Okay. So this syllabus consists of the physical chemistry, inorganic chemistry, organic chemistry and applied chemistry. So the syllabus is very huge, that consists of 16 chapters altogether. But the syllabus is divided into these four parts. So beginning with physical chemistry, it consists of 5 chapters. So you must be feeling that this is a huge syllabus. Don't get afraid. I am going to make it very simple and joyful for you. So physical chemistry consists of the solid state, solution, chemical thermodynamics, electrochemistry and chemical kinetics. So the solid state consists of the crystal structure, their packing efficiency and the defects. Okay, so we are going to see various point defects, the band theory, the semiconductors and conductors, then the solution chapter, which consists of solubility and then dependence, various dependence of solubility on the factors, then the Henry law. Okay, it also consists of the expression of colligative properties and the dissociation constant. Then also it consists of strong and weak acid bases. The Ostwald dilution law is the important law of this chapter. Then the role of buffer solutions and what are actually buffer solutions and how they help in controlling the pH. Next is the chemical thermodynamics, which consists of us to understand the first and second law of thermodynamics. Also, the workout change in enthalpy, entropy and Gibbs function in physical and the chemical transformation. Then application of Hay's law in thermochemical equation. Then come to the fourth chapter, that is electrochemistry, which consists of strong and weak electrolytes. The various laws related to that, then the electrolytic and galvanic cells, their half cell equation. Then we are going to even see in this chapter the various type of electrodes, the Nernst equation and their importance. Then what is dry cell and strong batteries and fuel cells also we are going to study here. Then next is the chemical kinetics, where we are going to study different orders of reaction like zero order reaction, first order reaction. The collision theory of reaction rates, actually chemical kinetics as the name is suggesting you, states the rate of the reaction. And we are also going to see all the numericals related to these 5 chapters. So physical chemistry involves all numericals and formulas and derivations. Okay, so we are going to see this in detail. Next comes the inorganic chemistry. So inorganic chemistry consists of the periodic table, correct? So that you have seen last year in 11th standard. Even that time you have studied the S block elements and few of the P block elements. This year we are going to study the remaining few P block elements and even the D block elements. So the question is, where is on the screen the D block element? So this is the D block element, transition and inner transition elements. And the group 16, 17, 18 elements are the P block elements. So we are going to cover them in detail. We are going to see their electronic configuration, the anomalous behavior of oxygen and fluorine, the allotropy of oxygen and sulfur, the structure of oxyacid of sulfur and halogen, the various chemical preparation and chemical properties of various compounds, the xenon compounds and their structures, and even we are going to see actinides, lanthanides over here. Next is the coordination chemistry, where we are going to cover the EAN rule, the Werner theory of coordination compounds, the various hybridization for predicting structure, the CFT sketch and various other things. So that is all about the inorganic chemistry. And then comes the organic chemistry, full of mechanism. Afraid of it? So don't get afraid. It is like just like a game. So these chapters include the halogen derivatives, alcohols, phenols and ethers, aldehyde, ketones and carboxylic acids and amines. So these are the four chapters of organic chemistry. So these chapters all have the same pattern which you have to follow. First the introduction, then the IUPAC nomenclature for all these compounds, and then come the preparation and synthesis part of this all compound, and finally their reactions. And end of the chapter, each chapter here ends with the application of them. So this is all about organic chemistry, and organic is a very interesting chemistry. Okay, so next is applied chemistry. So what is applied chemistry? The application of the chemistry. So here we are going to just cover three chapters. That are biomolecules, introduction to polymer chemistry, green chemistry and nanochemistry. So what are biomolecules? The molecules found in nature. Those are carbohydrates, amino acid, nucleic acid. Here we are going to see the various way to draw the structure of this biomolecule, such as Fischer projection, Howard projection, Howard formulas, okay, then the structure of DNA, nucleic acid, then their stability. Next chapter is the polymer chemistry. So there we are going to see polymer, the polymerization, then their various rules, laws and their stability and reactions. And finally is the green chemistry and nanochemistry. So this is very important for this 21st century, the green chemistry and the nanochemistry, because green chemistry include the reactions where you use the very, very low amount of chemical, and that helps to keep our environment green, and that's why it is called as green chemistry. And next is the nanochemistry, which has various application in today's world. So we have to understand scope and application of the nanochemistry, gain the knowledge of a synthetic matter and properties of nanoparticles, and also to characterize these nanoparticles. So that's all for this. So thank you for watching this video. If you liked my video, please give it a thumbs up and share this video to more and more of your friends. Meet you in the next lecture. Stay tuned. Thank you.